Close your eyes. What do you hear? You can hear the flap of the joust. I can hear space invaders. Dun, 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 dun. Star Wars. You can hear the guys jumping on Donkey Kong's foot. Galaga. Bringing that ship down and hitting double fire. The sounds and the ambiance that come off of these machines when there's more than 50 of them in a room is better than any 80s song ever written. I'm Richie Knuckles. In the industry, I'm known as the best. There was a locker that was abandoned, so they contacted me instantly. We take the classics and we restore them back to their original glory. I'll toss in $500 and a bottle of hot sauce. Just like Mozart, when he first saw the piano, he got in front of it, and the next thing you know, the guy's composing masterpieces. I kind of felt that way about arcade games. If you want an arcade game that looks like a beautiful work of art, you come to me. This is the holy grail of arcade collecting. Now, I've been looking for this game since I was 19. I am 46 years old. I got it for maybe a couple $100, put close to $800 into it, but I could sell it for $3,000. A pinball machine that I could have bought 5 years ago for $2,000 is now $8,000.
I am not into it. You ever think of getting an office job?
Richie calls me when he needs a hand. Otherwise, I don't even think he knows my telephone number.
I had a lady call me yesterday, want me to buy her whole basement collection. She's got like 15 games.
My father looks at the games and sees just, you know, rotting old pieces of wood. Doesn't realize the value behind the machines.
He's not where he should be because he was focusing too much on getting world records.
Space Invaders, I would say, is my signature game. I got a Space Invaders tattoo. I played this game for 6 hours straight, tripled the world record that was set back in the 80s.
World records are great. World records are not gonna make you money. It's all about business. You're gonna have to segment some of that money into marketing. It's not gonna be easy, Richie.
We're at my warehouse. This is where I do a lot of my work and I store a lot of the games. To the normal person that walks into this warehouse, they just see a bunch of old garbage that really have no value. But what that really is the parts. I'm doing an event called the Kong Off, but not the Kong Off 2, the Kong Off 4. In the night. I have to make 22 by the middle of July. Todd! Todd! Anybody see Todd?
We have several thousand machines.
Richie is not a threat to my business. He's a threat to his own business.
We both restore old video games. It's just we differ on the aesthetics.
Well, I'll show you what I got for you. Look at this Donkey Kong. 35 years old, and it is beautiful.
The only thing, of course, you know what's bothering me is the white buttons. The original Donkey Kong came with orange and then two blues.
You can change certain elements of the game. It's fine.
I love the guy, but some of the things he does to the machines, to me, is sacrilege. Did you put a new power supply in it?
Yes. Oh, don't tell me you're keeping the old crappo 35-year-old power supply. Richie, listen, you've got to make these things last.
The stuff he'll take out and throw away and put new, I'll go pick that stuff up out of the dumpster and bring it back home and rebuild it. Oh, my God, what's that white monstrosity? What's that thing?
The customer asked me to paint this Nintendo cabinet white.
Well, it's kind of sad because everyone knows I'm out scavenging the earth for blue Nintendo cabinets.
The customer is always right, Richie.
I have to admit, if somebody said they were going to give me $1,500 to paint over one of the blue Donkey Kongs right now, I would have had to let it go. I'd say, no, I can't do it.
Richie, we got to knock some sense into that head of yours. You're going to have to do something or you're going to be out of business.
There is a big difference in our business model.
I got to find a happy medium. I got to figure something out so that I can still keep my purest values, churn out Michelangelo's, and still make a profit.
If he doesn't get real, real soon, his game over light is going to be flashing merrily away.
So Some of these machines I've been hunting for years. They're diamonds in the rough.
This one right here, this goes for top dollar if it was in great shape.
Richie needs to take the arcade to the next level.
When I set out in this business, there was two things I could have done. I could have done quality or quantity. I chose quality. Have I paid a price for that?
Yeah.
Every month, we struggle to cover the bills.
Where is my Wizard of Oz? This is gold. Many collectors would pay top dollar for this.